In this video, I'll show you how I set up road style brake and shift levers so that they're perfectly aligned and symmetric with respect to one another. That's right, no more guessing whether or not your left lever is slightly lower than your right, or whether your right lever seems slightly more turned in than the left. Welcome! This channel features reviews, how-tos, and general bike nerdery, all filtered through this extra average cyclist with a technical background. If you want to join this community of like-minded cyclists who value smiles per mile over miles per hour, then be sure to subscribe to the channel. In my opinion, setting up road-style shifters has to be one of the most frustrating tasks because the levers can seem so free to move around, which is a good thing for dialing in your fit, but a nightmare for obsessive tinkerers. Now, before we fully dive in, it's worth mentioning how to actually move the levers with respect to the handlebars. Most road-style levers are secured to the handlebars via a metal band that's tightened by a hex bolt. Now, usually it's a 5mm bolt, and you'll have to peel back the rubber hoods to access them. On some other levers though, the bolt is actually accessed by sliding a hex wrench up the hood along the side, and so peeling back the hoods isn't actually necessary. But in any case, to move the levers, you'll need to loosen this bolt, and to secure the levers, you'll need to tighten it, usually to a torque somewhere between 6 and 8 newton meters, but it's important to follow the manufacturer's recommendation on this. Anyways, so on to the alignment technique. Now, personally, I'm wired to think in engineering terms, and it helps me to visualize the nature of the adjustment if I can break it down into two modes or degrees of freedom. Now, basically, to fully constrain the position of the lever with respect to the handlebar, you just need to recognize and define what I'm calling the Z dimension, which is the distance to the lever along the handlebar as measured from the endpoint, and theta, which is the angle of rotation of the lever about the bar's central axis. Now, if you can wrap your head around these two degrees of freedom, then it really simplifies the alignment process as we can tackle them one at a time. Now, generally, my advice for setting up levers is to fully set up one lever exactly how you like it and then tighten it down right off the bat. Then use the following techniques to align the opposing lever to match the first side. Now, I know this sounds obvious, but I've seen others try to align levers simultaneously, sort of cinching down one side and then trying to match the other side, and going back and forth, which seems to make the process take longer than necessary. Okay, so for the Z dimension, or in other words, the lever height, in my experience, the best way to ensure that both levers are equal is to reference a line spanning the two to the handlebar itself. Now, fortunately, this is pretty easy to do and doesn't require any special tools. So once your first lever is set up how you like it, roughly get the angle of the other lever to match the first side. Then, taking a length of string pulled taut across symmetric points on both levers, see if that string is parallel to the handlebar by comparing reference points on either side of the bike's central axis. Now, if they match, then the levers are of equal height. But if the string is rotated with respect to the line of the handlebar, then just adjust the height of the lever until the string is parallel to the handlebar. Now, make sure that the string is at a point on the hoods that's sufficiently far from the mounting point on the handlebars, as this will take advantage of geometric amplification, and you'll get finer resolution to work with when making your adjustments. A pro tip here is to have the clamping bolt cinched up reasonably tight so that it takes a bit of force to actually move the lever that you're adjusting. Now, this serves two purposes. First is that it takes any play out of the system, so when you eventually go to tighten the clamping bolt down, the lever doesn't shift during this process, which can sometimes happen if there's extra slack in the clamping strap. Also, having some tension already on the clamping bolt allows you to make very fine adjustments and have the lever stay put even when you let go. In other words, it prevents you from having to support the lever in place while you make these fine adjustments. Anyways, I think the string method is the best way to get the height of the levers perfectly symmetric since you're comparing them to the handlebars themselves. Also, once you do get the height adjusted on both sides, it's worth putting a mark on the handlebars themselves just underneath the lower edge of the metal straps, just in case one gets knocked out of alignment down the line. Now, the theta adjustment, or in other words, the rotation of the levers, can be a little bit trickier to dial in. To get the rotation adjustment symmetric on both sides, what you want to do is to find some reference plane on your handlebars. What this means is that using a rigid plate, like a piece of stiff foam board or even a hardcover book, you can create a symmetric reference plane that's common on both sides of the handlebars by supporting the board against three distinct points on the handlebar drops. Now, usually this means supporting the board against the flat portion of the drops at the very end and then rotating the board inward until it makes contact with the third point on the bars. The point of doing this is so that you can establish a common plane of reference that'll be symmetric on both sides of the handlebars, and you can use it to dial in the rotation of the levers. By extending this plane out to the levers, you can get symmetric rotation on both sides by fixing the distance from the levers to this reference plane. Then the idea is to go to the other side of the bike, create the same reference plane by supporting the same rigid plate against the same 3 points on the handlebar drops, and then rotate the lever until this X value is the same on the other side. Now this will ensure that the rotation for both the levers is symmetric, and since the height of the levers was already adjusted in the first part of this process, you can now be certain that both levers are completely symmetric. And most importantly, remove any nagging doubt that your levers aren't quite the same on both sides. Now if you're happy with the positioning and you don't think you'll modify it much, you can make marks on the handlebars as an alignment gauge in case you need to remove the levers in the future. Why a simple grid to help align your brake and shift levers isn't just printed on every bike handlebar is really beyond me. I really think it'd be such an easy thing to do. In fact, lots of handlebars actually have scales printed on them to get the height adjustment, but I've yet to see any with longitudinal scales printed on them to dial in the rotation. If all this sounds like too much trouble, I don't blame you. This level of tinkering and obsession is not something I would say that I'm proud of. Rather, I do it out of necessity so that I don't waste any time on long rides staring at my handlebars, wondering whether my levers are symmetric or not. And instead, I can just enjoy the ride. In any case, hopefully you found this method useful. And it's not just theoretical either. I've actually been using this method for years to get my road style shifters perfectly symmetric so that I can spend time appreciating the nature and fresh air rather than suppressing anxiety over whether my levers are symmetric or not. Anyways, that's going to do it for this tip. Thanks for watching and thanks for subscribing if you haven't already, and I'll see you next time.